Hello everyone, my name is Mihir Gandhi and today we'll look into the suspension system of a car. First we'll start by looking at how we select a springs, dampers and bearings for a car, followed by steps involved in designing major suspension parts. We'll also look into the major points we need to keep in mind while designing a suspension system and different types of simulations required for a Formula student competition. Let's look into how we select springs, dampers and bearings. There are essentially three types of springs: leaf springs, coil springs, and torsion bars. Leaf springs can take the heaviest of loads, but a drawback is that they are very noisy and bulky. So these can be commonly found in trucks and commercial vehicles that carry heavy loads. Coil springs can take loads similar to leaf springs, but a positive thing is that they are not accompanied by noise. They are light, compact, and thus can be designed as per requirement and installed in a car as per space. So these are most commonly found used in automotive and motorsport industries. The third type of spring used are torsion bars. Since these are just rods, they can help save space, and the ride height can also be adjusted according to requirement. So these are generally found in bulky vehicles like military tanks and trucks, as they have low range for shock absorption. For selecting bearings, we need to determine the conditions like speeds, loads, lubrication, etc. And we can use the SKF catalog available online to find out a suitable bearing. There are two types of dampers used: monotube and twin tube dampers. Monotube dampers are better than twin tube dampers, as they offer better response, offer ease during installation, and have superior damping ability. So they offer a better ride quality. Now we look into the steps involved in designing major suspension parts. So to begin with, we need to take into consideration all the vehicle specifications like wheelbase, track width, ground clearance, and various other parameters. Then we can decide the type of suspension we are going to use in our car. After that, we will decide the hard points of the suspension system, as they will decide the static settings like toe camber, caster, kingpin inclination, scrub radius, mechanical trail, etc. After the basic geometry is established, we can determine the loads that are acting on these parts, and using all this above information, we can perform a kinematic analysis virtually using softwares to understand load distribution and various other parameters like camber gain during cornering, change in roll center height, etc., and we can optimize the performance. After tuning our suspension system according to requirements, we can finally make a detailed design of different parts like wishbones, uprights, etc., and further make changes according to requirement. So some major points to keep in mind while designing a suspension system are that a suspension system is entirely dependent on the tire mechanics. So it's essential to have accurate tire data, as all the calculations like camber, caster, camber gain, and all suspension geometries are dependent on tire data. And second, we need to understand that camber, caster, and kingpin inclination, toe, etc., all the suspension geometries are interrelated, and any change in these parameters can change all the other parameters. So all the factors should be taken into consideration while designing a suspension system. Also, we should take care that while designing the suspension parts and optimizing them, they should be made such that they can be easily machined. And the wheel travel should be less than the ground clearance. Now let's look at the different simulations required for a general Formula student competition. We use three different simulations, namely Adam's car, ANSYS Simulations and Lotus Suspension Analysis. Adam's Car is a software that is used for vehicle structure and suspension system analysis. It is used to optimize vehicle modeling with respect to suspension hardpoints and also used for kinematic analysis. This same thing can be done using MATLAB, but in MATLAB, we have to build a model, whereas in Adam's Car, the model is built into the software and we just need to input our data. Second type of simulation is ANSYS simulation that is used to optimize the parts of the suspension system. So we can find out the maximum stress regions and after entering the loads acting on the different parts, and we can reduce weight or attain the desired factor of safety. The last type of analysis is a Lotus suspension analysis. This is a software. It is used to lay out the initial suspension hardpoints, and we can view it in a 3D environment and drag the hardpoints as required. So this software is used for designing and improving the static dynamic behavior of the system. Various results pertaining to the kinematic behavior, like the suspension geometries like caster, camber, toe, the roll motions of the car, etc., can be displayed, are displayed graphically in the software, and by moving the hard points on the screen, we can see the these values changing, and we can optimize the suspension system. Thank you.